Are you having problems with your back hamstring? Is your back hamstring very slow or doesn't it look very good? In this video, I'm gonna help you improve your handstand. I'm gonna improve your back handspring, of course. I'm gonna give you all the tips that I discovered that improved my back handspring and how I managed to like pull a backflip full twist out of a back handspring. If you wanna do that, if you wanna accomplish that combo and more, this is the video for you. Respect the skills.
Respect the skills.
Leave a like for Leo and here we go. Workout Wednesday. So of course, for the first whole minute warm up, boom. Warm up for the first minute, especially, of course, your wrists. Like that, or like that. Arms backwards and forwards. Can't forget your neck. Legs. Twist everything. And now, do a little bit this. This stretching your back, you know, and your shoulders and your arms backwards like that. And also your neck backwards. So just everything backwards, like that. For the second minute, this is one of the first key things that I discovered that improved my handstand, maybe the most. And it is, you have to let your knees shoot forward. Don't jump up with your knees. Let your knees shoot forward. You want to make sure of the back handspring. It's the exact opposite of a backflip. With backflip, you want to go down and all the way up. Like almost vertically 100% up. With the back handspring, you don't want any height. Okay? Sounds weird. But that makes the back handspring a lot cleaner, a lot easier, a lot faster, more powerful. If you immediately go into the rotation, okay, and you don't want to go up, because the more you go up, the slower your back handspring is. Yeah, this is it. The longer the time between the moment that you take off with your feet and the moment that you place your hand, the longer that time is, the slower your back handspring is, the less clean it's gonna look. Make sure you place your hands as fast as you can. This is the movement that we're gonna spam for 1 minute. Let our knees shoot forward. You don't want to do this, but you want to do this. Okay, shoot your knees forward. So now we're gonna do this, okay? Jump onto your back or into a kip-up. I can't really do a kip-up, so I'll try. You can also just land on your back. Make sure you have something soft. You don't have to jump high at all. Again, you don't even want any height with the back handspring. So rotate as fast as you can. And also your hips forward, by the way. I forgot to mention that. Knees forward. Hips forward and don't go up, immediately everything backwards. So for the next minute, this is a very quick one, just really make sure you stretch out as much as you can, put your arms together like that and just go backwards. And also if you do your back handspring, really make sure your arms go first. Your arms have to be the most backwards of your whole body. Don't throw your arms like that, keep them here. Go into the backflip and try to place your hands again. If you go into the back handspring, you don't want to only like throw your arms. With the backflip, it is this motion. You throw your arms like that and your arms go back. With the back handspring, you want to keep your arms like this throughout the whole flip. So don't go into the back handspring, back, and then try to place them again. Keep your arms here as far as you can. That is the tip that helped me the most if I want to combo the back handspring. If I want to do a backflip, or a backflip full twist, of course. After a back handspring, this is it. Keep your arms not here. Really keep your arms as far as you can. And this stretch helps with that the most, okay? Here we go. We're already a couple seconds too far. The more flexible you are, the easier this back handspring is going to be. The easier you will be able to combo this trick. What you can also do is just stand like this and try to see the ground behind you. Not like this, but really like that. Like with your arms, not like this. But with your arms, so of course, without falling over. And that is a stretch that will improve your back handspring, okay? Next step. So this one is a little bit different. Now, we're going into a handstand. So you might be wondering, what does a handstand have to do with a back handspring? Well, we can simulate the end of the back handspring with the handstand. What we're gonna do is, I recommend you do this on the solid ground and not on an air track, but I'm gonna do it on an air track anyway, just to demonstrate it. Go into the handstand. You don't have to be good at the handstand, but you wanna stand on your hands straight for like 1 or 2 seconds, okay? So go into the handstand and then, very simple, kick your legs. So bend in your knees and kick your legs towards the ground and push off with your arms. That's literally it. First, I'm gonna explain the legs. Watch my legs, okay? So like this. Oh, that was pretty nice, actually. So, that is it, with your legs. So, go into a handstand like that, legs like this, and then kick out. And with that kick, you create a lot of backwards momentum, a lot of power. That is the exact same movement that you make, that you do with the end of the back handspring. So, of course, with the back handspring, you go backwards on your hands, and then you're standing on your hands for like half a second. But then you don't want to just fall back onto your feet or something. You want to bounce off your hands. You want to place your hands. You want to push off and kick with your legs at the same time. So instead of this is it. Instead of this, when your feet are on the ground, your hands have to be gone already. So not like this. It's so slippery. Did you see my right arm? My hand was going for a little slide there. Anyways, you can see my feet were on the ground, but my hands were still there. That's not what you want to do. You want to do it like this. I'll insert a really good, I'm not going to do it now because it's wet. I'll insert a pretty good back handspring of mine. Just check my feet are on the ground and my hands are already gone. Here you go. So that is the next step, okay? Learn to push off with your hands. That is where the handstand comes in real handy, because it is literally exact same movement as the end of a back handspring. You know what? I'm gonna leave the handstand tutorial in the comments. Check it out. You really don't want to skip this trick. Next step. For the next step, also to get used to this whole motion, you know, you want to reach as far back as you can. One trick that also helps with this is the backflip layout. If you can't do a backflip layout on the ground yet, just do it on the trampoline. And if you can't do that, learn the backflip layout first. It's really not that difficult. Just spam, okay? Really spam everything. You do want to make sure, if you can't do a backflip layout yet, you want to have a really clean backflip, okay? Before you move on to layout, of course. I just want to have that set. Okay, I'm going to do it on a trampoline because it's going to go terribly wrong here. Of course, with the layout backflip, you want to be as laid out as possible. And that's the same with the back handspring. In terms of that, the back handspring and the backflip layout are pretty similar tricks. The only difference is with backflip, you land back onto your feet again and you want some height. But with the back handspring, instead of the backflip layout, with the back handspring, you don't want any height. And of course, you're gonna land on your hands. Well, actually, you're not landing on your hands, you're placing your hands. And you're placing them like that, and you're pushing off like a couple milliseconds after it. So it's a really fast movement. That's the next step. Let's just go to the trampoline real quick. But now we're on the trampoline. Something popped up in my head. Of course, one way to get even better at your back handsprings is to spam it on a trampoline. Trampoline. That's also one of the reasons that I got very good at my basics. Just spam it over and over and over again on the trampoline. It's very easy. You don't have to put in a lot of effort on the trampoline. And because of that, you can focus on your technique. Decent. Backflip layout. Here we go. And if you spam that, you will get used more to this motion. Oh, also one thing. Normally with the backflip layout, you don't really, like, you use your arms, of course. But now, if you want to get better at the back handspring, just use your arms just like you would use them with the back handspring. So try to simulate the back handspring with the backflip layout as much as you can. So don't throw your arms like this and then stop. Really make sure you use your arms and go all the way like that. So like this. So as you can see, my arms weren't here. But like all the way there, you will get used to that motion and your back handspring will get a lot better, faster, cleaner, more powerful, and you will get your combos with the back handspring. So here we go, The last step is, of course, the back handspring itself. This is not a back handspring tutorial, by the way. This is like a tutorial on how to improve your handstand. I mean back handspring. So wait, let me say something. Throughout this video, I said handstand probably a lot of times. When I say handstand sometimes, I talk about back handspring. Of course, now the last step, back handspring, all the steps together. Hips forwards, knees forwards, you don't want any height, chin backwards, arms, like flexibility all the way backwards. Warm your wrists, really make sure you get stronger wrists. Push off with your arms, kick your legs towards the ground, and most important of all, that's how I got very good at the back handspring very quick. I'm not very good at it, I'm pretty good at it, like decent, but I got decent at it very quick because I spammed this back handspring like crazy. In the summer, the blue sky, the blue air track, the grass was green, the weather was nice, everything was on point, and I progressed so fast. And I immediately comboed it to a backflip, to a backflip full twist, to another back handspring. I'll insert some clips right here, 3, 2, 1, respect. Okay, so yeah, that were a couple combos that I achieved pretty quick because of these tips, okay, that I just gave you now. Put all that stuff together and just spam. Do it every single day. 50 back handsprings, okay, that's a lot. But just, I don't know, just spam it, okay? Very simple. The more you do it, the better you will get at it. Guys, I hope you enjoyed it. I hope you got value out of this. I hope your back handspring will be a lot better with this video. It has to be, because it did for me, so it's gonna work for you. Of course, everyone learns a little bit different, but yeah, use the tips that you wanna use. So if you can't do a back handspring at all, I'll make sure that the link of my tutorial is in the comments. And there was another episode of Wilco Wednesday. It is dark as shit. It's a lot darker in real life than on the camera. Yeah, it's more like, whoa, what? It's more like this. Is it more like this? Yeah, it's more like this. It's really dark and... Whoa, that was hard. Respect the skills.
Respect the skills.
Leave like for Leo. He's sleeping inside. Oh, look who we found. Leave like for, you know. Whoa, look at that. Okay. And yeah, stay tuned 5 videos a week. I gotta say what I'll say. Have a great day. And I'm gonna catch you on the flip side. Peace. Between the moment that you take off with your feet and the moment that you place your hand, the longer that time is, the slower your back handspring is, the less clean it's gonna look.